The top 7 qualities you want in your divorce lawyer. Are you thinking of getting a divorce? Have you been buried under the information overload from Google Grandpa searching for a good lawyer? Are you at that stage where you think spending your life in an unhappy marriage with a shitty asshole spouse is less painful than finding a genuine lawyer who gives a crap? Then keep watching this video. Finding a good lawyer is a crucial step in your divorce proceedings, and a divorce can sometimes cost more than the entire freaking wedding. But if you play your cards right, that is, if you follow my pointers in this video and other videos on my channel on this topic, you just might be able to get through this. So, here we go. Point number one, he doesn't hate on you or flirt with you. Now, most people might find this unusual, but here's the thing. This happens mostly with women. When women are going through a divorce, most of the time they are heartbroken. They are seeking attention, love. They are vulnerable. They are feeling lost. And a vulnerable woman is seen as an opportunity by creepy men. So when your lawyer sees you in that state, they're gonna try to hit on you. And this is something women have told me themselves, which is the only reason why I'm saying it outright. There are many lawyers who have tried to flirt or exploit a broken woman who is seeking a divorce. So if your lawyer tries to do this with you and somehow give you the impression that if you have sex with me, then maybe I wouldn't have to pay money or I'll fight for you, this and that, whatever fake promises he's making, try to get this message that if he tries to flirt with you or he's trying to get a date with you or hitting on you or whatever and tries to meet with you aside from your regular legal meetings, then that means he's not a good person. Run. Point number two, sure, he's not too busy or skimpy with his or her time. So someone who is a very, very successful lawyer might either cancel appointments or completely forget about them or delay meeting you and say, yeah, I'll see you tomorrow, and then they'll call you the next day or 2-3 days later and say, oh yeah, I got busy and this and that. You want someone who's successful, of course, because someone who's completely free is an indicator that they might not be a very good lawyer, which is why they don't have business. But if someone is also too busy, they are completely delaying meetings with you, and if they do give attention to you, if they do set a date with you, then their attention is elsewhere while talking to you, that means they are not going to give full effort into this case, and this is not a person you want fighting the most probably important case of your life. So yeah, this is not a good person. The third quality you need to look for is that they listen more and talk less. So what happens is that I have seen lawyers who try to put words into your mouth, and they try to feed you false information, and they go so far as to feed you lies, and they force you to lie. They tell you that if you don't lie, you will never win this case. You should accuse your spouse of doing this or that, or especially when it comes to women, because women are afraid, or they are easy to manipulate when they are vulnerable. So these lawyers, what they would do is tell women and their families only win the case if they accuse the husband of domestic abuse and this abuse and that abuse. It'll take it too far just so that the lawyer can win the case. And you don't need to do all of that, because clearly if you are seeking a divorce, you have a good reason, and that reason should be good enough for you to get a divorce, and you shouldn't have to lie for something like this. That is already in your court, that you already have the right to get. So this is something. And of course, when they listen more, then they will understand your dilemmas. They will understand if they have any conflicts of interest. Anything that has to do with a person hearing you out, having empathy for you, and trying to understand where you're coming from. If your lawyer is trying to do that, that means this is a good person and this is someone who is going to defend you. So go for it. Number four, he doesn't catch phrases that mean run. So what do I mean by catch phrases? Hear me out. First, revenge. I'll take revenge for you. Second, teach him a lesson. I'll teach him a lesson for you. Third, he can't get away with that. There is no way in hell we're gonna let him get away with that. Fourth, he says something like, I'll ensure he loses and apologizes and bring him to your feet, blah blah blah. Fifth, he says something like, you're gonna win big, you're gonna have the best things and this and that and blah blah blah. So when a lawyer says these things, that means they are unprofessional and they don't know how the court system works, because the way court system works is there are no guarantees. And if someone is making these big claims, they are not basing that claim on any guarantee. They will never put that on paper and give it to you in writing, because then you can sue them for that. But when someone says these things, they are manipulating you. They are trying to take advantage of your bitter feelings that you're feeling right now towards your spouse, because they know that you are in that mental space, and they are trying to capitalize on that. They are giving you a confirmation bias. They are saying you things that you think you want to hear, but then these are not real, genuine, professional things that a lawyer should be saying. So run. Number five, he sets reasonable expectations. So this can be seen as the extension of the last point. And by reasonable expectations, what I mean is that a lawyer should be able to give you two things: best case scenario and worst case scenario. Worst case scenario, if you lose, this is how much you are gonna lose. If you win, however, this is how much we can win for you. Now, when I say reasonable, genuine, logical expectations regarding your financial matters, what I mean is that if you're claiming alimony and child support, if your husband's salary is 20,000 a year, you cannot claim £1,000,000 for alimony. Those things are unrealistic expectations, because whatever you are expecting, the other party needs to be able to afford that. And if you are asking for ownership in the house or whatever assets there are, there have to be reasonable expectations, and there have to be at least a possibility in your mind that you can win and you can also lose. So what happens if you lose? What are you going to lose if you lose the case? So these are the few things that you should have in mind, and basically your lawyer is the one who should be telling you about these things, just so that there are no doubts or there are no unreasonable expectations. Sixth point is that you should get a positive vibe from this person. So apart from professionalism, what you can expect is that if this is someone who has same views about things, let's say childhood or parenting styles or the rights of woman, things like that, if this person has similar understandings of the world. They share the same worldview, or this, they look at the world with the same lens that you do, then it's highly likely that you get a positive vibe from this person. What I see most of the time is that women tell me this from their own personal experiences, that when they see a lawyer and they talk to them about the things that have happened with them in the house, the emotional abuse, the physical abuse and things like that, if the lawyer is saying that, oh yeah, it's a husband's right to slap around a wife, it's no big deal, this is not something that we can file a case on, but yeah, I'll do that because we can then exaggerate that he did this many times and you can get it. So not only is the person lying, but also the way they say women, the way they think about women's rights, they are either gaslighting you or victim blaming you or shaming you about something. These are not the kinds of things that will make a woman comfortable with a lawyer like that. So you want your lawyer to be someone like that. When I say no friendship but good amicable relations, is that obviously you shouldn't think that your lawyer can be your friend. With a lawyer you need boundaries, but with a friend you are lighthearted, you are easy, and there's no boundary. So for example, you're setting a meeting to see your friend and they come 15 minutes late. You're okay with that. You're gonna just say that you waited for 15 minutes and they're gonna give them your excuse, give you an excuse, and you're gonna laugh about it and you're gonna forget about it. But when a lawyer becomes your friend, then it becomes harder for you to be harsh with them and to tell them that you've been waiting for 15 minutes and this is important time, this is not your chilling time. So if they are your friend, you would be afraid that you're going to hurt their feelings and things like that. So this is not what you want to do with a lawyer. With a lawyer, you want to have good relationship, a respectful, professional, but not friendship. The seventh point, last point, that make sure he or she doesn't talk funny about money. What I mean with that, they're not too vague, they're not too generous, they're not too stingy, they're not too scammy, things like this. But too vague means they are not giving you a definite number about how much your case is gonna cost or what are their consultation fees or whatever their charges are. They give you different numbers at different times, or they give you vague numbers. Yeah, we can talk about this and that and that, and they keep giving you hope that this is gonna work and something like that. So this is not something that you wanna go for. Next thing, too generous. This goes into that flirting part. They're gonna, oh, you are someone's a friend of a friend, and oh, this is we just think of this as your own office, you can get comfortable around here, you don't need to worry too much about money. This is not how a good professional lawyer would talk about money. They would be straight with you. So not someone like that. By too stingy, I mean this is someone who's billing you for 50 pence that they spent for a fucking photocopy paper, and they're keeping track and record of something as minor as that, or on the way to see you, if they grab the coffee, they're charging you for that. So for someone who's keeping that much, who's so money minded, who's keeping score of this much amount of money, even this is not a very good person to be around. So they are gonna create trouble when it comes to money and when it comes to expectations. So because you are the one who's holding money, they'll only get a certain amount of money from you, and then when it would be out of their control, they would try to cut down their services to make you suffer. This is someone like that, so don't go for someone like that. So these were the seven most important things that you should look for in a lawyer, the top seven things. I tried to keep this video as short as I could because the topic is so long, and if I go into the depth, then the video can be even longer. But I hope this helped you, and goodbye.